Perfect.
Hey there, friends. It is me, HLModTech, and it is spooky season, so I thought I'd give you one last super quick lesson that's pretty darn fun in Tinkercad. So, my friends, let's get cracking. All right, so let's start by getting in and grabbing Scribble. When you bring your Scribble out, click it to launch it, and then I want you to try and draw something cool and spooky. Maybe try and draw a bat, maybe try and draw a pumpkin, maybe try and draw a ghost. You make what you want. I'm going to draw a simple pumpkin shape, and I'm just going to do the outside of it and the stem. Not going to add any details, I'm just going to click done. And then my big rule is that we always shrink it down to 2 millimeters thick. Now here's where it's going to get kind of cool. I'm going to do Control D to duplicate. I'm going to go to the second one, and I'm going to double click to edit it. And now I'm going to use that sweet little fill trick to fill it in. Remember, you don't have to be perfect. You can do this more than once. Just drag around close to the edges to get it filled. When you're done, let go. Go back and get the little pieces that you missed. If you ever mess up, you can just do undo. But get that all filled in, something like that. There's so much room for you to do this way cooler than I am. So with these two pieces done, I can now take the first one and I can raise it up to the second one. We're going to do that by using the work plane. So I put the work plane on top of our second shape. And now when I hit the letter D, it drops to that exact height. I'm going to shut off the work plane by going back to the normal blue edge. And when I do a line, I want them to be aligned in the middle on the side and the middle this way. And check it out. My pumpkin now has a sweet three-dimensional look. I want to keep those together, so I'm going to group them, simply grabbing both so they're selected. Notice it says two shapes, and let's click the group button. I want a hole for this little keychain. Real quick reminder, see this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 centimeters. If you're under 70 centimeters and 50 centimeters, you are probably in a range that you could talk me into printing it. I'm going to bring out a hole. I'm going to hold shift and I'm going to shrink it a little. Notice that moves everything at the same time, and then I know that 5 is an awesome size for a hole, so when I type 5 in the box, it all squeezes to that size. I'm going to grab it, move it, and put it where I would want my keychain hole to be. You can also nudge it with your arrow keys. When you've got it in a spot that you think is good, you may hit the group button to cut out that awesome hole on your keychain. Now you can add the awesome pieces to your little keychain using more Scribble. If you want to set them on the face, or if you want to set other pieces on the face, remember to put the work plane there. I'm going to just give mine a cool little Scribble smile. I'm going to make it kind of look like sharp teeth. Do the same thing underneath. I don't know if this is going to look good, but at least it's kind of a funny thing. I'll throw it in there. Remember the rule where you set it to 2 millimeters thick so that it fits. I don't know if that's good or not, but it's at least something. And then I'm going to do the same trick to add eyeballs. I'm going to make my eyes have a hollow spot in the middle and hit done. Once again, set that height to 2 millimeters. I'm going to zoom back out to the full size, nudge it with the arrow keys. I want to get closer to just this shape, so I'm going to use the fit view to selection. This is actually looking unbelievably silly, but you know what? That's half the fun too. You can come up with something way cooler than me. I'm gonna do Control D to duplicate that eye. I can do crazy things like stretch it and grow it to make it look silly. I'm gonna go back into my Scribble tool and make another piece just because I thought of something that I thought would be fun. So there's Scribble dropped on the work plane, and I'm gonna give my pumpkin little eyelashes, because I can. Once I hit done, I'm going to shrink them down to that 2 millimeters. Typing the number almost always seems faster. I'm going to use the rotate tool to rotate it so it looks the way I want. zoom back out so I can see a little more. I'm going to use the minus button this time, which I rarely use. Get that eyelash so it's the way I want. Squish it a little bit. I'm going to do Control D to make a duplicate, and then I'm going to use a really cool flip tool to flip it so it actually looks the other way like I wanted. Drag it where I want. You're only going to be able to print this in one color, but if you want to make them two color shapes, you can have fun and make them look colorful on your screen as you make your awesome Scribble character. All right, friends, as you can see, there is so much room for you to play and have fun with this. Make sure you take time to name your project, and if you make something awesome, make sure you share it with us on Facebook, Instagram, or Twitter at HLModTech. And lastly, friends, if you had fun with the lesson, please give it a like. If you got a question, comment, or a suggestion, add it down below. If you haven't subscribed yet, what are you waiting for? Smash that subscribe button. And last but not least, hit the notification bell if you want to be the first to know when there's a brand new video from me, HLModTech. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.